Diligence. Success is not a magic. Success don't just happen. Men intentionally and persistently take drastic steps to make it happen. Diligence is the key. What differentiates a man affecting nations from a man that barely affects a village is diligence. What makes a man to stand before kings and others before men is diligence. What makes a ministry to prosper and others don't is diligence. You know, what makes ministry to prosper in some people's hands and it seems ministry is not prospering or not working in other people's hands is diligence. So, diligence is the key. The question now is, what is the opposite of diligence? You know, the opposite of diligence is slothfulness. A slothful person loves things easy. He loves shortcuts. He resents working hard. He's not ready to invest time to attain excellence. For him, anything goes. You know, he is after the reward than the price. He's after the money than the process to get the money. He is just scratching the surface of his purpose. He's afraid of going too deep so as not to deprive him of pleasures. He doesn't want to give up his circle of social friends so as to feed his social ego. He wants to gain the approval of everybody. You know, he's a people pleaser. He doesn't care about his value, but what will other people say? What will they say? What will they think? You know, and this is the brief description of a slothful person. You know, success, like I said earlier, is not a magic. Success don't just happen. Men intentionally and persistently take drastic steps to make it happen. A public speaker said, he said, "Before I give any speech, I rehearse it like 100 times before the D-Day." That is what we call diligence. Picasso, Pablo, you know, whose one of his painting can cost millions of dollars. Not even can cost, it cost millions of dollars. You know, he will invest 3 months to brainstorm on what to paint. Three good months to brainstorm on what to paint. You know, he will invest months again to study all the elements of his paintings, after which he will now take his painting brush to slash a sketch on his canvas. And even the sketches might be running to several hundreds before painting the masterpiece. Now tell me, why won't his painting be worth millions of dollars? That is diligence. You know, your diligence in an endeavor communicates how much value you place on it, which will in turn determine how much value others will place on your work. Perhaps you've been saying, okay, why is it that I will say my product cost 2 million naira and people are offering 200,000? Why? Because of the value that they attach to it. And the value that people will attach to your product is directly proportional to the value that you attach to your product by spending time to make sure you produce a masterpiece. So, value what you do by displaying diligence. Are you a public speaker? Be diligent at practicing. Be diligent at meeting with people. Be diligent at doing what you love. Spend time. Like I always say, Gladcom said that a professional who's a person that has invested at least 10,000 hours in his endeavor. So be diligent enough to give it the time. To give it the time. Practice, practice, and practice so that your work can be a masterpiece.